We are honoring to have my kids here with us today. So, בעזרת השם, where were we? We were in Torah Lamed in Likutei Moharan. That we said that a person have to have a worthy rabbi. We are in paragraph Gimel, third paragraph in Likutei Moharan. Amen. Paragraph Gimel, paragraph, third paragraph. וזה בחינת שערות, and רבנו is saying, it's an aspect of hairs, שההערות, that the light, המוחין, that comes out, that comes out from the brain of the person, יוצאין בשערות, they're coming out in the hairs of the person. כן השכל העליון, also like that, the highest wisdom, שהוא השגות אלוקות, that it's achievements, השגות, of Hashem, to know Hashem, who mitlabesh ba'sechel ha'tachton, it dressed himself in the lowest wisdom. Vezeh bechinat, and it's an aspect of sara be'igula, that the hairs comes out in circles, they're round. Bechinat sibuvim, an aspect of all of the circles, the haynu ha'akdamot, means all of the introductions, hamsabevin, that we should surround our wisdom, toda rabba. עד שבאים אל המכוון כנ"ל, until that we're reaching what that we wanted to achieve. והעיקר הוא המכוון. We learned all of that. We learned all of that. שרת הבת, we learned all of that. בואי סי. Wonderful, we're gonna learn it again. והעיקר הוא המכוון, כמו שמצינו בדברי רבותינו, like that we learned, there is a main thing that the wise person he wants to teach, but to come to that point that people are going to understand what he's talking about, he needs to have a lot of explanations before, introductions before. So we found it in the Gemara, כמו שמצינו בדברי רבותינו זיכרונם לברכה, שסיבבו בהלכות עד שהגיעו לצרת הבת, that they were explaining a lot of introductions, a lot of explanations before that they came to the main thing that they wanted to talk about. Nimtza, we found by that שכל ההלכות שדיברו מקודם, that all of the הלכות that they were learning before that they came to the main one that they wanted to talk about, לא היו עיקר המכוון. They weren't the reason that they were talking for. רק, just only, היו סיבובים והקדמות, just it was introductions and circles that they were surrounding before, כדי להגיע לצרת הבת שהוא המכוון, because they wanted to talk about that thing that was important before. וזה בחינת, and it's an aspect of שערה וקמה, that the hair is black, בחינת שחורה אני ונבה, I'm black and I'm beautiful, כי השחרות הוא מקבץ את הראות, because the black color, he is bringing the his when a person is looking on something bright, on light, he cannot focus in it, he can focus only on dark colors. This is actually the secret of the satisfaction of the world to come. In the world to come, everyone that's going to have a share to the world to come, they're going to see Hashem. Everyone going to see Hashem. But, like we said just now, Hashem is illuminating, Hashem is light, Hashem is white. What are you going to see? It all depends in how much you grabbed Hashem when you were here in the dark world. In this physical world, if you got Hashem, if you saw Hashem, you're going to be able to recognize Hashem in the world to come. But if you haven't recognized Hashem in this world, in the world to come, it's all going to be light. It's all going to be bright. You won't be able to see nothing. Only the tzaddikim, the righteous people, in the world to come, they're saying, "Zeh Hashem kivinu lo." This is Hashem that we hoped for him. Means this is Hashem, means something that we saw already before. When you have a situation with a police officer, when you have a situation with your wife, if you're saying it's Hashem, so in the world to come, when you're going to see the real face of Hashem, you're going to say, I saw those faces before. It was my wife, it was that police officer, it was that situation in the bank, it was all Hashem. You're going to recognize Hashem. But if you weren't seeing Hashem, you were ignoring from Hashem, in the world to come, you're going to see something. You will not going to know what you see at all. You won't have no satisfaction from that sight, eyesight. Zagenom. Maybe there is two kinds of hell. There is hell of fire and hell of snow. So maybe it's hell of snow. Snow white, we said, right? כי השחרות, because the black color, הוא מקבץ את הראות. The eye can focus only on the black, on the dark light colors. הוא מצמצם אותו כדי לראות היטב. And he is closing it, that the person gonna see very, very good. Also, you can see it in the, how you said, ishon, the hole that we have inside the pupil. Nice. English is amazing, mamash. You can do whatever you want, always. No one gonna stop you. And everyone gonna nod and gonna agree and gonna say, yes, pupil, whatever you want. Amazing. Yes, so that pupil, he is shrinking, he's getting smaller. If when a person needs to see more precise. So you see that the black is closing himself to see better. It's exactly what that we learned. כן השכל התחתון. Also the low wisdom of the person. הוא בחינת שחרות. He's an aspect of those dark colors. שמצמצם בו, that he's hiding inside of it, נבע ויופי שבשכל העליון. The beauty and the grace of the higher wisdom. Means you're looking on something that is simple in this world. If really you're gonna focus, you're gonna observe what it contains, you're gonna see huge, high, amazing, enormous, beautiful things that are coming from the source of the creation, from Hashem Yitbarach himself. ואלו השערות, and those hairs, הן בחינת שיעורה דעתוון דאורייתא. They are the aspect of the amounts, of the size, of the letters of the Holy Torah. כי המצוות, like that we know that the Torah is written, it's written that the Torah is black fire on top of white fire, on the back of white fire. Mean the sheets, the papers of the Torah, the sheets, they are the cloth, they are white fire. And the letters are black fire. Actually, if you're gonna look, and it's, again, it's that wisdom. The white, you cannot enjoy from the black without the white, and you cannot enjoy the white without the black. So, if a person just gonna try to enjoy the paper, the white, the blank paper, it's infinity. This is the endless. This is what that we said. You cannot enjoy it, the white fire. You cannot have nothing, even though that everything is written on that white blank paper. Everything, you can write whatever you want. You just need to write it. Everything is written, it's waiting, it's optional, it's all over there, but you cannot enjoy it. Only when they're shrinking it, when they're making it written, and now you cannot change it anymore, and it's not moving nowhere, then you can start finding the light of that white fire, by the black fire. So you can see from that, that the person cannot enjoy from the world to come without being in this world. Even though that this world looks like hell, even though that this world is full with suffering, full with difficulties, full with tzimtzumim, holy difficulties. But only by those difficulties you can recognize Hashem. You can learn about Hashem. You can recognize Hashem. You can enjoy, can satisfy yourself with the being of Hashem. Because without it, you're just going to cancel yourself to the infinity and you don't have no vessels.
It's like
לא למטה, למטה, ליד איפה שקנינו את העוגיות. אברהם יבוא איתכם.
So if you're good in this world, you'll get the letters in the next world. If you get to be able to understand
their sources, their source.
And if you don't,
in this world you can enjoy also. There is people that enjoying Limud HaTorah also in this world, enjoying praying also in this world. But really, to know Hashem, you cannot know Hashem Yidbarach in.
But you're saying this world is the black world. You're saying if you are good in this world, it's like you get the next world, the white, with this one on it, the black on it. You can read.
Over there you're going to recognize, look, on a blank paper, on a white paper, written all of the letters that are written in all of the books. So if you learned all of the books, so in the world to come, when you're going to see that white blank paper, over there, you're going to see it all. But if you learned only one book, so you're going to be able to see, to recognize only what that you saw. You understand? They're helping the person to achieve in the world to come what that he achieved in this world. He cannot climb to achieve more than that, means in a wider space than what that he achieved. He's gonna achieve everything that he achieved in the highest way of them all. Okay, means that, like Rashut HaYachid, we know that the area, the how you say Rashut HaYachid?
Private domain
of a person is the, it's it's a dalet amot, it's four amot, but on four amot, but the height of it is until heaven. It's climbing, it's, you have infinity to the heights, okay, and also to the depths, as much as you're gonna dig, you're gonna have. So you see that to the heights you have endless, but the measure that you can achieve is as much as you conquered in this world. If your house is 100 meters, so you have 100 meters until heaven. If you have 200 meters, you have 200 meters until the end. So a person needs to achieve more and more and more in this world, and in the world to come, he's gonna enjoy all of it until heaven. But this is why you need to learn another book, and another book, and another book, and to do another Itbodedut, and to recognize Hashem on that person's face, and on that in that situation. And in every situation you can recognize Hashem. You can mamash recognize Hashem. The thing is that to get closer to Hashem Yitbarach, this is something that we all need to understand. It's not something that's gonna be by the rules of nature. Because Hashem, He is the creator of the nature, means that He is beyond nature. So if really a person is getting closer to Hashem, so the rules of nature are not forcing him. They're not, cannot stop him. Money will never gonna stop him. Hunger will never gonna stop him. Nothing gonna stop him. His wife, his kids, nothing gonna stop him because he's with Hashem. Actually, this is the thing that we need to understand. When we have the opportunity to attach ourselves to HaKadosh Baruch Hu, we have an opportunity to attach ourselves to something that is endless. And if HaKadosh Baruch Hu has got all of the powers and you're canceling yourself to Him, you become to be like that also. You can fly, you can do wonders, you can make miracles, everything. It's written that David HaMelech, he was flying. He was saying a name and he was standing in the sky. It's written like that, just by pshat, and we believe in that. We know that there are righteous people that have huge, enormous powers. Mamash, abilities that beyond the logic of a human being. Avraham Avinu, he took sand from the ground and he was throwing it, and it becomes to be arrows and hasech chanitot, swords and arrows that were flying with the wind to conquer, to beat his enemies. He got superpowers. Where from? Because that his faith was beyond nature. So the rules of nature cannot cover him. He's beyond all of that. He sees a person that comes to attack him, he just ignores from that person. He knows that it's all Hashem's movements. He's not afraid from nothing. This is what we need to remember, that when we're attaching ourselves to Hashem Yitbarach, there is no borders anymore in that place. And every one of us can make miracles, and every one of us can have wonders in his life. And there is nothing that can stop you from achieving that, nothing, except of your sadness and your imaginations and your lack of faith in yourself, no, he can be a righteous man, I see it, but me now, Hashem cannot help me. Why Hashem cannot help you? No, I'm too lazy, no, I'm this, no, I'm that. You're convincing yourself in all of those nonsense. That you're too old and I don't know what. That you're too lazy, that you're too tired, that you're too poor. I don't know what, it's all nonsense. It's all craziness, it's all imaginations. It's all, from the first to the last, it's all imaginations. HaKadosh Baruch Hu has got the power to do with you whatever He wants. Moshe Rabbeinu was 120 and he was making miracles when he was 120. His eyes was perfect, he could see everything, his body was in shape with powers, he wasn't going to the gym, and no nonsense at all. He was just learning Torah and Sirut Nefesh, learning day and night and serving Hashem and running to help to people. And he was a soldier of Hashem Yitbarach, and Hashem is giving him the powers. Now you, when you're coming to the field, when you're coming to pray to Hashem Yitbarach, you need to approach to Hashem Yitbarach with confidence. Hashem, look, I'm serving you. I'm working for you. Whatever you want me to do, I'm doing. So now, I need to do something for you. Even if it's to buy a house, to marry a wife, to learn all of Shas, all of Talmud, Bavli, Yerushalmi, you want to build a huge center to teach Judaism to the nations. I don't know what you want to do. Whatever you're gonna decide that you need to do to serve Hashem with it, you should have the confidence that Hashem is with you in that. If not, so it's not partnership, you're not together. He's doing whatever he wants, so. He sent me to this world to serve him. So now I'm serving him and he's gonna be there with me. To support me, to heal my wife, to heal my kids, to help me, to provide me whatever I need. I don't have a doubt on it. If I have a doubt on that, so why I need that kippah for? If there is a doubt if he's gonna be with me in the day that I'm gonna need him, so who am I serving? The one that is not loyal, Chas Shalom. I need to be loyal, not him. He is loyal. He's for sure loyal. He's the truth. He for sure gonna be there with me. I need to work on myself that I'm gonna be loyal. If I'm gonna be loyal, Borei Olam will not be there with me. He will not gonna be there for me. He will not gonna provide me all of my needs. Even if I'm gonna need $1 million a day, or $2 million a day, $15 million a day. What is gold and money? It's all in the hands of Hashem. Hashem created the world. Now it's hard for him to move the money. Well, he needs boats, he needs aeroplanes. What he needs? When Borei Olam wanted all of the people to run to United States, so he revealed the gold over there, and everyone running, chasing, Abalal Zahav, chasing after gold, running, want money, want gold, and all crazy people gathered themselves to find gold from all the corners of the world. Ran, why? Because Borei Olam revealed gold. Alright. Now we can reveal something else in a different place, and everyone gonna drop United States and gonna run to that place. You know what he gonna reveal? He gonna reveal himself. Where? In Zion. Ki mitzion tetzeh Torah udvar Hashem Yerushalayim, and words of Hashem from Jerusalem. Vebayom ahu, and in that day, everyone gonna throw the idols of money and gold and gonna say, hey, what is it helping me? I have huge amounts of money, huge amounts of gold, and I'm not happy, and I'm frustrated. One of the friends told me that his mother calling him and telling him, look at your brother, he's in United States, making so much money, everything that he's touching, he's making it to be gold, it becomes to be gold. He's in prison that made out of gold. He's in prison that made out of gold, and he cannot escape. Because this prison is closing on him more and more and more and more and more. Creating more gold and more gold and more gold and more gold, and he cannot go. Cannot escape. What are you gonna do? But you are outside and you're a refugee. And you are a refugee. If you're here, you're a refugee. You escaped. Borei Olam helped you. One day you're gonna understand what he saved you from. We don't want to know. But one day you're gonna wake up and gonna realize what really Borei Olam was doing with you when he saved you. when he gave you that opportunity to come to yeshiva, to learn Torah, to talk to Hashem every day. Once it was a flood, second it was a war, third there was fire comes from heaven, I don't know what, tsunami, how you call all those craziness, storms, yeah, hurricanes, disasters, and people are stuck in their fears and anxieties and they don't know how to escape. You give them the option, you tell them, you're more than welcome, you can come, Eretz Israel is wide, is open, everything is good, you can serve Hashem. And they're in anxiety. Why? What are you afraid of? There is more Ishmaelim in the United States than here at Eretz Israel. What are you afraid of? You're afraid of Ishmaelim? There is more in New York than in Eretz Israel. All imaginations. In Eretz Israel you can find Hashem, and outside of Eretz Israel nothing that you're going to do is going to help you. Maybe Hashem is going to send you hints, maybe he's going to flag, he's going to do things for you that you're going to wake up, but just because he wants you to come to Eretz Israel, he wants you to live in Eretz Israel and to live in Mesirut Nefesh in Eretz Israel with all of the difficulties. All of our fathers had difficulties, those difficulties built our fathers, gave them the faith and the strength to fight for Hashem Yitbarach and to get more people and more people to know Hashem and to recognize Hashem. It's written on Avraham Avinu that he was going from city to city and screaming in the center of the city and shouting things that people gonna think that he's crazy. And people would chase after him and he was running outside from the city to the fields, to the woods. And there he was sitting and relaxing them and explaining to them what he was shouting. There is Hashem. Avraham Avinu, Rav Shalom said that Avraham Avinu, he was himself hosting, giving the food and helping the people that would come to his house. Why? He was rich. He could have servants, meshartim, that gonna do that for him. Waiters that gonna do everything for him. Why he was doing it himself? Rav Shalom said, because he wanted to talk to each and every one of them and to tell him, here, the food is from Hashem. Say bracha. Say thank you Hashem for the food. Thank Hashem. When people would tell Avraham Avinu thank you, he would say, don't thank me, thank Hashem. He is the creator. He is the one that gives us everything. This was his will, his real will, to teach people faith. He's the head of all the nations, all of believers in the world. And all of the faith started from Avraham Avinu. And people had faith and they fell from it to weird places. Few of them believe in idols now. Few of them believe in bigger idols. Few of them think that they believe in one God. Everyone have his thoughts. Everyone have his faiths. But it's all full with lackings when you don't believe in the real one, in the real creator. That it's the one that created the world. It's the one that share with his wisdom to the nation of Am Israel and gave the wisdom to that nation. That nation gonna illuminate the world with the light of Torah Kedosha, and to do it all for all of the creatures of Borei Olam. Borei Olam is a real Rahman. He doesn't like you more than he likes someone else. He likes everyone. He loves everyone with his loving kindness to all of the creatures, to a bee, to a mosquito, to I don't know what. He's got rachamav al kol ma'asav. His mercy is on all of his actions, creatures. HaKadosh Baruch Hu, he's mamash ready to help. And if you're asking, how can it be that HaKadosh Baruch Hu, he helped that person and another person, he didn't help him? How can it be? Why you're telling me that HaKadosh Baruch Hu gonna help me when I'm gonna need him, but that person, when he needed Hashem, Hashem didn't help him? So the only answer for that is faith. That person didn't have faith. He didn't have faith in that situation. Because HaKadosh Baruch Hu, he have to lead you according to your faith. And if you don't believe that Hashem gonna be there with you, he cannot be there with you. Even if he wants to, he cannot be there with you. But if you're fighting all of your life in the darkness, in the suffering, when you're suffering, to fight with your Yetzer Hara, I want Hashem here with me. I want to believe in Hashem. I don't want to have all of this crazy satisfactions of this world. I want Hashem here. I want Hashem in every situation that I have. Hashem going to be there with you in every situation that you're going to be in. And He's going to reveal Himself to you. Rabbi Yehuda Ze'ev Leibovich told the story that when he was before of the Holocaust in Hungary, he saw there was a person that he was a teacher, a rabbi in the Talmud Torah, and he was over 90 in Hungary before of the Holocaust. And that person, he was a very good man. When he saw people that comes out from the bathroom, from toilet, and they had toilet paper stuck to their shoes, he was going, how you said, bending down to take those toilet papers from their shoes, that they won't have shame, that people were not gonna see that they were in the bathroom. This was that character. After the Holocaust, that Rabbi Yehuda Ze'ev Leibovich was in Auschwitz, and he was in few camps, and he was in Auschwitz, and he saw mamash hell on earth, mamash. And he came here. When he was here, suddenly he saw that person, over 90, walking in Eretz Israel. So he asked him, how you got here? Because for him, after that he was in Auschwitz, he knew that everyone from Hungary almost came to Auschwitz. And he knew what was in Auschwitz. He knew that for sure that person couldn't survive in Auschwitz. So he asked him, how you came here? So he told him, I don't know. They just brought me to here. And Rabbi Yehuda Ze'ev Leibovich explained that angels took him from Hungary and brought him to Eretz Israel because of his kindness, because of his good midot. Just took him from Hungary and put him in Eretz Israel. Just like that. Just like that, you don't need to have no nature. When Rabbi Aaron Mibelz, the students forced him and told him to run away from Belz to save his life. They forced him almost. Where is the juice? Where is the bag? And I don't remember the verse, but while they were running and the Nazis mamash came to Belz, came to the city where they were, and in the middle of their running, while they were running, suddenly he stopped and he asked to bring him a chair and he wanted to sit. And it was a crazy act, chas v'shalom, so to speak. What are you doing? We're running. What are you doing? And he said, I don't remember the verse, that it's not allowed to run when you're scared. That we're not supposed to be scared from Haman HaRasha. That you're not allowed to be scared from Haman. We're not afraid from him. We need to run, so we're running. But we're not afraid. We're not running because we're afraid on our lives. We're running because we decided to save our lives, because now we decided that we should do that, this and that. Also, when one time he was in Jerusalem and he needed to go fast to Tel Aviv, he was living most of his life in Eretz Israel in Tel Aviv, and also I think in Petah Tikva, but I'm not sure. When he one time went out from Jerusalem very late, before of entering Shabbos, and there was a fear of Chilul Shabbat, they were afraid that they're gonna Mechalel Shabbat because of the time. When they came out from Jerusalem, he told them, stop the vehicle, stop the car, went down close to Motza, went out from the car, he asked them to give him something to sit on, and he sat on that, maybe it was a box or I don't know what, and he sat over there. They asked him, what are you doing? We're afraid to break Shabbos. He told them, we're not allowed to be scared. We have to do everything benachat, not allowed. All right, you need to go fast, we're doing it, but benachat, with Hashem, not a tzarim. Everything benachat. Everything with Hashem Yitbarach. With Hashem Yitbarach. Not to be afraid. Not to be intense. You haven't been married yet. You're not married. What you gonna do? You don't have an income. You don't have parnasa. When I came to this yeshiva, maybe 10 years ago, I talked to Rav Yaakov Herzberg. I told him, Rav Yaakov, what I'm going to do? Well, the first thing that I've been told when I came to the yeshiva, I asked him if I can learn here in the yeshiva. They told me, yes, you're more than welcome, but you cannot have money. Parnasa, maskoret, we're not giving. You can learn, no problems, no paychecks. Said, okay. Said, okay. And I told Rav Yaakov, I told him, listen, I don't know what to do. Now I have 40,000 shekels in my bank account and I can live a few months from that. But what I'm gonna do when it's gonna finish? He told me, when it's gonna finish, you're gonna be like all of us. We're exactly the same. We don't have money and we're coming daily to the yeshiva. This is the secret. When a person have confidence in Hashem, habotach b'Hashem, chesed yisovevenu, kindness gonna surround him. And it all depends in the faith of the person. If you have anxieties, maybe Hashem hates the person, maybe Hashem is angry at him, we don't know what's gonna be, Hashem for sure is angry, I wasn't davening right, I wasn't doing my mitzvot like I should have, you're thinking bad thoughts on Hashem. You're forcing Hashem Yitbarach to chase after you, to fail you in situations. You're forcing him. You're saying bad things on him and you are forcing him to lead you in a strict way, in a hard way, in an aggressive, offensive way. Just because that your faith is not complete at all and is far from being complete. This is why everything that we need to do is just to work on our faith in Hashem, that gonna be complete, that gonna be perfect, that Hashem is all good, that it's all kindness, that it's all mercy, that it's all wonderful. This is how Hashem wants, and everything is exactly like that Hashem wants, and it's all perfect. And then it's all gonna be perfect, you're gonna see it. It's already perfect, but it's gonna be according, corresponding to your language, to your thoughts, to your way of thinking. Aser etzoncha kirtzono. If you're gonna make your will to be like the will of Hashem, Hashem gonna cancel will of other people because of your will. Means that you're gonna find everything that you're gonna need when you're working on canceling your will to the will of Hashem. And what Hashem wants from you? מה השם אלוקיך דורש ממך כי אם ליראה אותו, just to be afraid from him. What it means to be afraid? Like that Rav Shalom asked, what it means? Is it a small thing, the Gemara is asking? It's a small thing to have Yirat Shamayim. It's not small at all. When you're attached to Moshe Rabbeinu, it is a small thing. When you're attached to real tzaddikim, it is a small thing to get closer to Hashem. Bond yourself to real tzaddikim. Learn books of real tzaddikim. Keep the advice of real tzaddikim. You're gonna be bond to those tzaddikim. This is the nature how things works in this world. When you're eating something, you become to be that thing. The Rav Gudlevsky said, you want to see a cow that puts tefillin on her head? Eat a steak, put tefillin, it's a cow that is putting tefillin. This is it. This is how you can make, force a cow to put tefillin. You're eating a steak and you're putting tefillin. You become to be that cow becomes to be you. It becomes to be you. So if you're eating and putting inside of yourself only good things, only holy things, you're gonna be holy. If you're nurturing your body and your soul only with good experience, with kosher food, with wonderful things, experience, you're going to Kivrei Tzadikim, Grace of Tzadikim, and you're praying, and you're learning Shiurei Torah, and you're talking to Hashem Yitbarach on your problems. Who you think you're gonna be in 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 7, 10 years? Who you think you're gonna be? If not a real kosher person, it's gonna take you a while. You have a lot of filthy water that you need to purify. Okay. But now you put that clean, clear water pipe into that bucket. It's gonna take a while. But with the time, another year, you think that you can change it? What, you can force the filth to stuck? Rabbi Akiva done tshuva because of that, because he saw that the power of the water is huge. It's very, very strong. Why? Because of their, how you say that? Consistency. Not because of the strength of water, just because you bringing another drop and another drop, another lesson in Likutei Moharan and another lesson in Likutei Moharan, another lesson in Likutei Halachot and another lesson in Likutei Halachot, another lesson in Gemara Masechet Brachot, another shiur Gemara in Masechet Brachot. One day you're dumb, it's right, you're dafuk, no doubt, we all. But one day the water gonna penetrate, they're gonna make a hole in that stone heart that we have. One day it's gonna happen. In a certain mitzvah, in a certain flight to Uman, in a certain mikveh, in a mesirut nefesh, when you're gonna one day gonna give a huge amount of tzedakah, or maybe it's just gonna be in et ratzon that you're gonna do something amazing, and Borolam suddenly gonna open the path for you. והולכים בחושך ראו אור גדול. The people that was going in the darkness, suddenly they saw huge light. אז היא בקע כשחר אורך. כשחר, like the sunrise. In one moment, היא בקע, suddenly, a crack, and this is it. Another mitzvah, הרב שלום said, even in that aspect of bringing people to do תשובה, to help people, he said, we do not need to bring all of the millions of Jews to do tshuva. We need to bring few thousands to do tshuva. The weight of those few thousands gonna bring the rest of the millions to do tshuva. Our job is just to bring another one to the purpose, another one to do sha'a, another one to do 1 hour itbodedut. Yafeh meod. Another one to come to Uman, another one to come to the mikveh, another one once to come with you to the mikveh, drag him, it's hard for him. He's gonna thank you after the mikveh. In the mikveh, he's still gonna curse you. After the mikveh, he's gonna thank you. After Shabbat, he's gonna call you and gonna tell you it was amazing Shabbos. During Shabbos, you're gonna think to yourself, what am I doing? Am I good? Am I wrong? If it's true, if it's I don't know what. All of the imaginations, all of Shabbos. Monday, Tuesday, you're gonna get a phone call. Thank you, I enjoyed, it was amazing, it was wonderful. It changed his life. One candle is illuminating huge amounts of darkness. A whole room that is dark, you bring one candle, you can manage. One candle, it's one mitzvah. Ner mitzvah v'torah or. A mitzvah, it's a candle, and the Torah, it's light. You teach a person the wisdom of Torah. What's the wisdom of the Torah? That Hashem loves us. This is the wisdom of Torah. This is what you need to teach. Hashem loves you. Hashem is with you. Hashem never gonna leave you. Hashem wants you to be happy. Hashem gonna be there with you. Just open your mouth. The door of the salvation, Petach Hayishuot, the opening of salvation. This is the letters of the word Pe, mouth. Petach Hayishuot, the opening of salvation. Just open your mouth. פתח פיך, open your mouth, ויעירו דבריך המהירים. And your illuminating words gonna illuminate, gonna come out. Open your mouth, fight! Fight with the yetzer of sadness, of depression. No, it's hot, I don't have the power. Also today, what? Every day? Every day, another drop, and another drop. One day you're gonna hear the sound of a crack, and this is it. You're a different person. Everyone that's gonna check himself gonna see a different person than who that you were 2 years ago, 5 years ago, 10 years ago. Look, there was a lot of crack noises already. A lot of them. A lot of light you have in your life. Just look inside, you're gonna see your treasures. Rabbeinu said, "Lechu chapsu et ha'otzarot shelachem." You should go and look and seek for your own treasures that you have inside of yourselves. Without awareness, without itbodedut, without spending time alone with the Creator in the field, you cannot know nothing about yourself. Who are you that you're gonna know? You have eyes, you have ears, you have wisdom, you don't have nothing. He is atachonen l'adam dat. He's the one that gives the wisdom. He's the one that is teaching. He's the one that created me. So he's the one that can teach me about myself. If you have a problem with your refrigerator, you're calling the one that made that refrigerator and you ask him, what should I do? The light is not turning on. I don't know what to do. He's answering to you because he created it. You need to go to the Creator that created you and to ask him, the light is not lighting, Borei Olam. It's darkness here. What should I do? I'm filthy. I'm not clean. I'm not working. I'm not waking up in the morning. How can I set myself to wake up in the morning? I'm waking up every day in noontime. How to set my alarm? Bura Olam, help me. I don't know how to do that. I'm trying to go sleep earlier. I'm sleeping 16 hours a night. I don't know what to do, Bura Olam. Trying to eat, not waking up. Trying to starve myself, waking up early and angry. I don't know what to do, Ribono Shel Olam. Talk to him. Another conversation, and another conversation. Another question, and another question. And then you're going to have the answer. And it's only one answer. Tshuva, Baal Tshuva. A Baal Tshuva, he's got one answer. Hashem, this is it. This is how Hashem wants. Means that also your lackings, it's how that Hashem wants. And there is no arguments on that. Hashem, he done, and he is doing, and he gonna do. Ribon al kol ha-masim, on all of the actions. Also the bad ones, yes. Also the difficulties, the laziness, the fears, the anxieties, the poverty. All of them, the Creator created them. And he's happy with them. He's happy that you're like that, with your lackings. Because with those lackings, you're honoring him so many times more than if he would created you to be an angel. Because the Bura Olam cannot have no satisfactions from the angels. Because they are set to serve him. And we are set to have options. And when you have the sea of options, and over there in the sea of options, you're fighting to find the path of truth, path of Torah, this is an honorable thing. This is an amazing thing. This is an important thing that Bura Olam is appreciating, that he's honoring. Ma? Matai okay. Now, עכשיו. Thank you very much. Chazak u baruch.